thanks for joining us. This is the Signature News Update. I am Damilola Abudu. In the headlines, again, gunmen raise police station, kill two officers in Anambra. Nigerians deserve good governance, from the legislature, Speaker, House of Representatives says. And now the details. Two police officers have been confirmed killed in an attack by unknown gunmen on the divisional police station in Obosi, Idemili North local government area of Anambra State. It was gathered that the attackers had, after burning down the station, moved to the quarters where they killed the two personnel in the early hours of Thursday. The command's public relations officer in the state, DSP Tochukwu Ikenga, who confirmed the attack to newsmen in Anambra on Thursday, said investigation into the matter had begun. According to him, the commissioner of police in the state, Chris Owolabi, had dispatched a tactical team for an on-the-spot assessment of the incident, and the bodies of the two policemen had been deposited at a nearby morgue. The Obosi police attack was the first such an incident since Owolabi took over from the immediate past CP, Monday Kuyas. The Speaker of the Night House of Representatives, Femi Gbajabiamila, says Nigeria deserved governance from the legislature. The Speaker, who was represented by Deputy Speaker Ahmed Wase, made this call at a two-day capacity building workshop organized by Conrad Adenua Stiff Thong for the House of Representatives Committee on Anti-Corruption on Thursday. He further noted that Nigerians rely on the legislature to combat security, poverty, corruption, and other challenges through their legislative capacity.
Nigerians are truly desirous of good governance and are looking to us to be the agents that will, through meaningful legislation, combat insecurity, poverty, corruption, and other problems.
The Speaker stated various agenda of the Night House of Assembly to tackle corruption, which he said include anti-corruption legislation, the possibility of establishing an anti-corruption court, separation of powers through constitutional amendment, among others. The Speaker further called on the anti-graft agencies present at the workshop to devote in fighting corruption through organizing capacity building workshops or to collaborate with the Committee on Sensitization Program to curb corruption.
Also in the document, legislative agenda of the Ninth House of Representatives, Federal Republic of Nigeria 2019 to 2023, the House noted four very critical areas to tackle corruption in the country. This anti-corruption legislation, possibility of establishing special anti-corruption courts, strengthening the fight against corruption through increased funding of the anti-graft agencies, and separation of powers through constitutional amendment process in order to separate the office of the Minister of Justice from that of the Attorney General of the Federation. To the anti-graft agencies here present, I wish to also encourage you to organize similar capacity building workshop or to collaborate with the Committee on Sensitization Programs to curb or reduce corruption in the country.
The Enugu State Government on Wednesday inaugurated the Board of Enugu State Agency for Universal Health Coverage to ensure effective administration of universal health coverage scheme in the state. Dr. Rob Sam Hawaii is the chairman of the board, while Dr. Edith Okolo, the executive secretary of the Agency for Universal Health Coverage, will serve as the secretary. Other members include the Enugu State Commissioner for Health, Dr. Ikechukwu Obi, Dr. Daniel Ugwagbo for Nigerian Health Economic Scheme, and Mr. Samuel Chukwudi from Nigeria Employers Consultative Association, among others. inaugurating the board at the Enugu State Government House. The Deputy Governor of Enugu, Mrs. Cecilia Ezeilu, urged the board to ensure that all citizens benefit from the health coverage. Federal government on Tuesday said it will reduce the salaries of civil servants and scrap some agencies so as to reduce expenditure. This has sparked reactions from Nigerians, as Signature TV correspondent Chibuezi Obi went to the streets of Abuja to receive Nigerians' reaction.
They therefore receive the salary of Senate and the House of Rep because they are not doing anything. They are the problem of Nigeria for now. For me, it's the Senate and the House of Rep. They are the more wahala that government have. If anything, they will scrap. Let them scrap the Senate and the House of Rep. It has no use.
I will advise the federal government to do, if it is to settle the National Assembly or the Senate, any of the two parties, then do a unicameral legislature. That way you save costs. So reducing people's salary, considering the rate of inflation, considering the cost of living, people will die. The same thing that happened last year where people were jumping into lagoon, the same thing will repeat itself.
Inside those money, there is school fees inside, feeding money, all those things they are inside. Then now you're reducing somebody's salary. Is there any profession for all those things? And now in Nigeria, let us be frank, let's see, many things are going up, understand, mostly food. And that is the thing that common poor man eats, understand. I buy a mudu of gari, common mudu of gari, 500 naira. Some people in some places, they sell it several 800 naira. Common mudu of gari. So how can you reduce those kind of salary with that kind of profession? It's not done. So for me, for civil advance for the governor or the president or the Nigerian, if they want to do such a thing, let them make a proper preparation for those things before doing those things.
Reducing people's salary is something that is going to cause more damage in the people of Nigeria. And it is unacceptable anywhere in the world. So I can say it is a taboo to do that. So I will urge the federal government to actually look into this matter very well and to do something that will benefit the citizens of Nigeria.
From time to time, prices of things increase in the market. Salaries have never increased. So how do you want the poor Nigerian to survive? It's so appalling. It's heartbreaking to see a country as Nigeria going down the drain. Now, if they want to reduce the cost of whatever they are calling it, let them start from those of them who are the apex of governance. We have been watching TVs, we see them lying down sleeping. When they say hi, some of them stagger from sleep and say hi, and that's the end of it. They have their children schooling abroad, so it doesn't bother them whether we are on strike or what.
Nigerians have taken to Twitter to mourn Dare Adeboye, the son of the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor Enoch Adeboye. The third surviving child of the 79-year-old general overseer died in his sleep on Wednesday at Eket, Akwa Ibom, age 42. Following the incident, many Nigerians have taken to social media to express sadness and condole with Adeboye and his wife. A member of the House of Representatives from Ondo East West constituency, Biela Makinde, commiserated with Adeboye family on the death of their son. Makinde tweeted, "I commiserate with Pastor Enoch Adeboye, his family, and entire members of the Redeemed Christian Church of God on the demise of his son, Dare Adeboye. I send a warm embrace to you to give you peace and comfort at this difficult moment. Kali have my prayers and positive wishes." In business, the Nigerian Communications Commission, NCC, and Nigerian Communications Satellite, NICOMSAT, have signed a memorandum of understanding to facilitate the deployment of 5G technology in the nation's telecommunications sector. Both agencies signed the agreement on the use of C-band spectrum for 5G services in Nigeria at an event held on Wednesday in Abuja, the Federal Capital Territory. In his remarks, the chairman of the board of commissioner at the NCC, Professor Adeolu Akonde, noted that in recent times, precisely from the last quarter of 2019, several administrations had begun to license spectrum for commercial deployment of 5G. NCC Executive Vice Chairman Professor Umar Dambata, on his part, said Nigeria cannot be left behind when several countries are already expanding their technologies through the 5G network. Let's join Brenda Atta for entertainment stories today.
Hello there, and thanks for joining us on Entertainment News. I am Brenda Atta. Nollywood actress Uche Obodo took to her Instagram page on Wednesday to announce the delivery of her second child. While she also thanked her fans for the love being showered on herself and the newborn, she wrote, "I just want to thank you, everyone. I see all the love, all the DMs, all the WhatsApp messages. They are overwhelming. I cry sometimes. Little me, do I deserve all this support? God bless you all. I can't reply all the messages, but I see them. Thank you. Congratulations, Uche. Welcome, baby. You're loved." Nigerian singer Peter Okoye, popularly known as Mr. P, just got lucky as he earned himself almost 40 million naira from a bet. He made the announcement on social media where he revealed that he is several millions richer following a Chelsea versus Madrid match that happened on Wednesday, May 5th. The entertainer had placed a bet with a certain individual and Chelsea's win earned him over 30 million naira. The singer also revealed that the same person is about to place another bet of over 70 million naira in the finals. Well, good luck, Mr. P, in your next bet. Ghanaian actor Prince David Osai, who campaigned seriously for the New Patriotic Party and Nana Akufo-Addo during the 2020 general election, has come out against the ongoing Fix the Country protests, and as expected, he is in support of the party he campaigned for. According to him, Ghanaians should fix themselves first, and this will translate into fixing the country. Taking to his social media, he wrote, "Ghana will be better and well fixed if we, the citizenry, fix ourselves first. Say no to hate, greed, selfishness, nonchalant attitude, tribalism." It's been more than 48 hours since Ghanaians stormed the Twitter platform with the Fix the Country protests to draw the government's attention to the hardships people are facing in the country. And some celebrities, including John Dumelo, Efia Odor, Yvonne Nelson, and Lydia Fosso, have joined the protest, highlighting some of the pressing needs of the citizens of Ghana. American TV star Khloe Kardashian's boyfriend, Tristan Thompson, has been accused in yet another cheating scandal. Tristan was accused by a model named Sydney Chase. Another woman allegedly came up also with other cases of infidelity. Model and Instagram influencer Sydney Chase appeared on a podcast and admitted to hooking up with Tristan after he got back together with the Kardashian sister. Sydney took to the video sharing app TikTok to apologize for disclosing personal information about Tristan. She went further to say Khloe allegedly messaged her privately to talk about the situation. To make matters worse, another woman has come out forward with a cheating allegation. Kim K claims that Tristan has allegedly been cheating on Khloe with other women with kids. The rich do have their own struggles. Till I come your way again next time, that's all we have on entertainment news. Thank you so much for listening. I am Brenda Ita.
On the foreign scene, the Republic of Congo's government have resigned on Thursday, a procedural move 3 weeks after the Central African nation's veteran leader began a new term as president. Prime Minister Clement Mohamba submitted his government's resignation to President Denis Sassou on Wednesday, according to the statement read out on television. The outgoing team will continue in its task until Sassou Nguesso names the new premier. He has not yet announced when he will do so. Sassou Nguesso was sworn in for a new 5-year term as president on April 16th. Mohamba, a 77-year-old former finance minister and senior executive of the Six Nation Bank of Central African States, has been prime minister since 2016. One of the world's longest serving leaders, Sassou Nguesso has been in power for an accumulated 36 years, first taking the helm in 1976. Before we end the news, here's a recap of our major stories. Again, Gunmen raised police station, killed two officers in Anambra State. Nigerians deserve good governance. From the legislature, Speaker, House of Representatives Femi Gbajabiamila has said. Please do well to stay safe, maintain physical and social distance, and wear your nose mask while going about your daily activities. That's a Signature TV News update. On behalf of my producer, that's a Signature TV News update. On behalf of my producer, Anita Eze, thanks for watching. I am Damilola Abudu.